Hey guys, I'm Bhava Tarani, Assistant Professor, Department of English Unaided Program, National College, Trichy. So in this video, we're going to see a basic introduction of the literary movement, the Renaissance, and also 10 particular causes of Renaissance in Europe. So this is a necessary topic that as a literature student, everyone must know, get to know about it, because there might be chances asking questions from this particular chapter in UGC NET and GRF as well. So moving to the topic, Renaissance, a literary movement. So in Europe, Renaissance literary means wake up again. And the cultural progress that was made in Europe between the 14th and 16th century is termed to be Renaissance. And as a result of this, there was this new consciousness came in every area of life in Europe, and this movement was not actually limited to the salvation of old knowledge, but in this era new experiments were also made in particular fields like art, literature and science as well. So there was also chances for new research that took place, and new ways of finding knowledge were also discovered. It distinguished humanism in the place of religionism. So religionism is nothing but excessive religious zeal that happens to be in Europe during this particular period. So the next one is, Renaissance was actually the movement by which the West's nation came out of medieval times and adopted the ideas and lifestyle of the modern age. And the residents of Europe made progress in geographical, business, social and spiritual areas. In this era, people have abandoned medieval monotheism and equipped themselves with new discoveries and latest ideas of social, cultural and intellectual advancement. So when we talk about monotheism, what it is all about? So monotheism is a belief in one God. When we get to know about its narrow definition, it is something, a kind of belief in the existence of only one God that created that world, and it is also omnipotent, omnipresent and omniscient. So the next point is, so now, every area in Europe has a completely new approach, which was ideal, and hope is thus communicated during this particular period. And the religion's influence ended on literature, art, philosophy, science, commerce, society, and politics. Thus, the Renaissance is the name of the intellectual movement that revived the ancient civilization culture of Rome and Greece and gave birth to new consciousness. So now moving to the causes of Renaissance in Europe. So we have 10 different causes of Renaissance in Europe. Among them, the first one is business and development of cities. So the most important reason for Renaissance was the development of commerce. So the business relationship of the people with the new countries was established, and they got an opportunity to know the culture and culture over there in several countries. And this business development gave birth to a new business class. And the businessman was a strong critic and staunch opponent for all those that happened during this particular development. And the business class also encouraged great thinkers, literary peoples and also scientists. So thus, the progress of knowledge science has progressed in the umbrella of the business class. There were many businessmen from many countries in connection with trade. There was exchange of ideas among them, and the intellectual development of the public was also exchanged with the ideas. So the second cause of Renaissance is contact East. So at the time when Europeans were intellectually backward, a new Arab culture had given birth to the Arabs. So the billion of empires spread to Spain and also Africa, and which particularly North Africa. They were also spreading their empire expansion along with the knowledge science. Due to the contact with the Arabs, the West also benefited. So the third reason is, third cause is tradition of medieval Pandit Panth. So based on the knowledge gained from the Arabs, the scholars of Europe emphasized the study of Aristotle. So he ran Pandit Panth tradition especially. It was the primacy of antiquity and authenticism. So what it is all about authenticism? Authenticism is a belief in the superiority of the authentic over the inauthentic, which means an attempt was made to revive ancient literature. So ancient literature was translated into various languages, and Aristotle's philosophy was the primacy of this particular philosophy. So the fourth cause is the invention of paper and printing art. So the contribution of paper and printing was important in pursuing the Renaissance in Europe. The printing of books and printing was started extensively with the invention of books, so that the ordinary person could also now read and buy books at affordable rates. So the books were written in language of the masses, so that the benefits of knowledge making started reaching ordinary people as well. So people started becoming aware of the work of different thinkers and also different philosophers. Thus they had gained the intellectual awareness. And the fifth one is cultural significance of the Mongol Empire. So the Darbar of the Mongol Emperor Kublai Khan was a meeting place for the scholars of the East and the West. His court was full of scholars, missionaries and businessmen from abroad. Interpersonal interaction between these scholars helped in the progress of knowledge science. They were also travelers of Europe, tried to use their method in their country by learning the method of producing gunpowder, paper and ship compass. Thus the Mongol Empire, they did the vehicle in the pursuit of Renaissance in Europe. The sixth one is fall of Constantinople. So what is Constantinople? Constantinople is an ancient city in modern day Turkey that is now known as Istanbul. So in 1453 AD, Osmani Turks took control of Constantinople, which was the center of enlightenment at that particular period. And after that particular conquest of Turks, there was this fleeing of disciples of Constantinople, and they thus seek refuge in the countries of Europe. And they also attracted the people's attention to ancient literature and knowledge. So this generated a new curiosity in the public with reverence for ancient knowledge, and this particular curiosity was considered to be the soul of Renaissance in Europe. There is another significant effect of the decline of Constantinople, that is the trade routes were closed between Europe and Eastern countries. So now the effort of reaching the eastern part of the waterway thus started, and thus Columbus, Vasco da Gama and Magellan have discovered many countries in this particular activity. So the seventh cause is discovering ancient literature. So in 13th and 14th century, scholars tried to revive the ancient literature, and among them there are many, including Petrarch, Dante Alighieri and Bacon. There were also scholars translated ancient texts into different languages and tried to introduce people to the mysterious subjects. Eighth cause is impact of humanistic ideology. So the Europe's medieval civilization was based on artificiality and core idealism. So philosophically, idealism can be defined as any of various systems of thought in which the objects of knowledge are held to be in some way dependent on the activity of mind. Thus, the worldly life was misconstrued. So the universities of Europe were studying Greek philosophy, and Roger Bacon opposed Aristotle's primacy and rendered the theory of rationalism, and this led to the development of humanism. The humanists criticized the fanaticism of churches and clergy as a result of this. So the ninth one is influence of crusade. For almost 200 years, there was a crusade between the East and the West, and the crusaders of crusade were influenced by Eastern civilization. And later, these warriors strengthened the foundation of Renaissance in Europe. So the 10th particular cause is decrease of feudalism. So what is feudalism? Feudalism is the dominant social system in medieval Europe, in which the nobility held lands from the crown in exchange for military service. So due to this particular practice of feudal, farmers, businessmen, artists and ordinary people did not get the opportunity of independent meditation. So the atmosphere was always toxic due to feudal wars. But the fall of the feudal system balanced the public life. People started paying attention to the progress of literature, art and business. So the important consequence of the decline of feudalism was the development of the national states, and people were born in a national spirit. So the quick summing up of all the 10 causes is that the first one is business and development of cities, and the second one is contact East, and the third one is tradition of medieval panditpant, and the fourth one is invention of paper and printing art, and the fifth cause is cultural significance of the Mongol Empire, and the sixth is fall of Constantinople, seventh is discovering ancient literature, and the eighth cause is impact of humanistic ideology, the ninth is influence of crusade, and the final cause is the decrease of feudalism, thus giving rise to the age of Renaissance. Thank you.